So hi, my name is Varun. I initially planned to be the guy who talked after lunch, so I was prepared to just say, should I say something funny? Should I start off by making people wake up and stuff like that? So I had to take a couple of slides off while the last talk was going on, so because he's nicely warmed you guys up for what I have to show you guys. So I don't come from an agency background. I was an engineer who decided one day to work in PR because it was for alcohol, and I got alcohol at a wholesale price, which seemed like a good thing when you were in college. Ended up joining a postgrad course in PR, moved in a month to audiovisual production. Sticking to one thing isn't one of my finest qualities, as you can make out from this. Joined MTV post that, worked at Channel V for a while, worked on reality TV. Which is why I also handle the HR part of our business. And you know, it's been a good 4 years since I started a company called Glitch. We set out to do stuff in the digital space. That's all we wanted to do. And we started off as a digital video production house, moved into becoming an agency, and now we're a good 90 strong team in Bombay, and we've done stuff on ground, digital, video, design, so we kind of flutter around whatever excites us. And I'm not a technologist, I'm not going to give you earth-shattering things, but I'm just going to talk about some basics which I really think, when you really want to taking an audience in a captive environment and connecting that to digital, what are the really key parts over there? So let's begin with, why am I here? Right, I just told you why I'm here. And then we go on to what I'm going to talk about, which is basically, am I going to show you really exciting technologies like this? I'm not really sure because I don't really even know what this is. How about this? Yeah, projection mapped dress. I don't really know how you do that on a sari. It's too shiny. But I think what we really need to look at is saying, what we need to do is this. You know, that's how we all got into the business. Whether you're an ad agency, you're a production company, you're no, whichever stream you're working, we all want to be those magicians who are pulling that rabbit out of the hat and your client goes, wow, this is what I really want to do. And that's what we should really focus on. You start with something simple and bring both digital and activation together because we tend to treat it like, I'm just going to go ahead. What am I going to do in digital for this event? It's a question I've heard a million times. I've spoken to many event agencies who call up and say, yaar, ek event hai, kuch karte hain digital mein. And there are words that come to mind. Does someone say live stream? You say holographic projections. Let's do a tweet up. Easiest answer ever. Send one guy with the phone and your job is done. Let's do augmented reality. Projection mapping, live tweeting. Let's do a Facebook login kar lete hain. But does that really end up giving you any value is another point altogether. Let's do an app for that. Let's do a mobile app. The mother of all inventions called a QR code, which everybody is really excited by. I personally never ever scanned a QR code in my life. I've run a digital agency for 4 years. I still don't get it. I don't even know how to scan it. So then when I had to do this talk, I said, okay, fine, I can't talk about technologies. That's not something which I'm really good at. Maybe I'll talk about some instances I've seen and what problems they solve. Some stuff which we've done. We've done a couple of things in the digital meets on-ground space, but I think a couple of those things we've done, we've had some fun with it. Yeah. Anything I missed? Actually, I should ask that question. No? Not really? Okay. Now think about what makes the experience of the event better. I think that's where we really need to start. And with that, we should ideally take it ahead. So we had an activation which we had to do. The main problem was that it was a young brand. It was a brand that was just going to launch a store. We need to get more footfalls in. We also need to figure out a way to do an activation where, you know, generally you have a long queue. And queues can be painful. You're waiting for people to get in, people get bored, they walk away, they don't go into it. So we did something called a tweet gun. I'm just going to quickly show a video.
taken a very beautiful dart gun and we've connected it with some beautiful technology. All you have to do is log into your Twitter and tweet about this activity that's happening over here. The tweet will trigger the gun to fire some shots at the DSL 55 logo as a backdrop. To actually trigger a gun by sending a tweet to 55 DSL, and if you shoot and you win goodies, that's like, that's awesome.
The event was awesome. Yeah. Mind blowing.
Like I'm a 30 plus year man, but still I was too excited to tweet it again and again just to see that how it actually flows from the machine.
So the past 3 days have been extremely successful and we really hope that something like this happens in other cities.
I'm very, very, very happy that something like this is happening in India. This is really innovative and a lot more of such campaigns should happen.
So yeah, so just figure out a way to jump the queue, because in most times, you know, you have that queue there. What do people who are not in that mall do? We did an online version of that. End of the day, people got a free coupon for them to get a discount at the store. Store footfalls went up. It was a simple solution. But at some point, we weren't really happy with that. So we said, okay, how can we really tweak this algorithm in further? So now we've kind of figured out a way for, you know, getting it to give people sampling. Figure out a way that when the keywords are coming out, specific things can be thrown at people, can be activated. So this is a good way to really say, okay, fine, it doesn't have to be a line of people waiting to get in. This is how technology can help. This wasn't a technology-driven idea. It was just trying to find a simpler way of doing things. There's another thing which says, you know, a lot of, you see something at a mall and you're saying, okay, fine, this is really cool. Then you go home and you forget about it. But some brands do some stuff which, you know, you tend to take home and it stays with you. Coke is always, I think you've already seen one which Coke's done, but this is a little different. Say what was digital about that is the fact that think of the miniature number of people who actually did that in that mall, but think of the thousands, millions who've seen that video online, and that's why a case study video is really important. We spent the least amount of money in get a guy to come with a camera, shoot what's going on, put it out there, but I think that's actually the thing which amplifies it out more. And plus, you can take the gift wrapping paper home, so you'll always remember that you did something and it's still with you. The mother of all things. Have no money to spend on promoting it. I have a week to do an event. What are we going to do? How we get more people into it? Question we've all been asked at some point of time. So Diesel was turning 2 in India. They were going to do a sale. The website got ready 1 week before the sale went on. They said, how can we get people onto the site, which gave them discounts to go on to, you know, go to the sale. So we did something which is not, I don't know if it's ethical, but this is kind of what we did.
Diesel was turning 2 in India and they're holding a sale across their stores to celebrate the same. An innovative campaign using a microsite was created to share awesome deals with the customers through QR codes and social auctions.
We didn't make the website.
The problem? How does one get the website popular? The big idea? The world's first digital flash mob. We use the most like-hungry and comment-hungry post on Facebook. The relationship status. At 5 p.m. on the 26th of April 2012, 500 people changed their relationship status from single to in a relationship. After enough heads had turned, each employee responded to all the LOLs, OMGs, WTFs and Are You Serious's with the message, "'Cause single is boring, twosome is awesome. DieselTurns2.com." Within 2 hours, the Diesel microsite received 30,000 visitors and 75,000 impressions were created in the next 2 days. The activity created enough buzz to garner loads of press and PR. Thus, the world's first digital flash mob rippled enough activity to make Diesel's second birthday party awesome.
So, why they said employees is because those 500 people were people from the Reliance Brands office, people from our office. We caught a couple of people from other places saying, do you want to be part of India's first digital flash mob? We didn't pay anyone. Just made people change it. The problem was some people were married and then they said in a relationship, it kind of created a bit of an issue there. But I think beyond that, everybody else seemed okay with it. So they had to go, actually, I know at least 10 people who called their wives and said, okay, I'm just doing this. People will call you, do not be alarmed. Yeah, so we just moved traffic. It comes from the changes of places. How are you going to get someone into an activation? What happens with digital a lot of times is people say, okay, fine, and I'll talk about an instance a little later. You get a person in, you give him a band, you make him log into his Facebook, he goes through 3 steps of permissions he'll have to do because Facebook works that way. And by the end of it, he's like, okay, fine, I've gotten this. Now, what is it really going to do? And that's not the reaction. You want him to say, I've got this, and what am I really going to do? And the next video, I'm going to push the video ahead a little fast. It's a little long. But the guys at Lakme came to us before Fashion Week, and they wanted a simple activity. They wanted people to put up photographs of themselves at Fashion Week, except the rush is so much that you're not going to have enough time to do the regular spiel of logging them on. But they also wanted it to look nice and give it a certain feel that you know this is from Fashion Week. So we did something over there which it's just kind of basic, but actually, it wasn't rocket science. We put a board with a switch under it. You stand on the switch, it activates the camera. The camera says 3, 2, 1, it takes a photograph, puts a nice graphic frame around it which says spotted at Fashion Week, gives a moderator from the Fashion Week team to, you know, see, okay, fine. Because at some points, there are, and how do I put it nicely? You don't want some kind of faces to go on the Fashion Week page, unfortunately. And so you know, you have a certain level of moderation there, and it goes up there. It's simple, right? What I've seen happen a lot of times is people will tend to do the other things which I've just said in terms of logging. You don't have to do it the longer way of log in first, then tag yourself into it. It'll automatically tag you on that. It's Fashion Week. People would want to tag themselves. We took that as a small gamble, which I didn't think it was a big gamble, and it kind of paid off. This is the biggest problem which I see. We all tend to say, okay, fine, these are all the technologies that are out there. What can I do with these things? You know, I've heard someone's done something with the Kinect. Can you do something with that? What I tend not to do is think, what do I really want out of it? And then the technology kind of like takes care of itself. You know, you'll find someone to figure a way to do it. This is a great example of it's just a simple idea, but it's... I was trying to find something because I need something which kind of summarize this, and that's, I know we all wanted to create, right? We want to create magic every day in terms of what we do, and you know, there was the Audi, and there was saying, how do we get people to go to a mall activation but yet experience driving the Audi? We said, okay, fine, it's primarily going to be guys in most of the places. They'll really get, you know, into the whole car and stuff, but they want to drive it. Took an iPad, made the entire driving interface for an Audi as an iPad app, put a screen in front, and we timed them. When they start driving the car, it's around the racetrack, and we did an entire online leaderboard. Simple, but the number of people actually got excited and kept playing it and kept coming back the next day saying, okay, maybe I can better my time. Kind of got the whole point across. We didn't actually have to get a guy into the Audi was right there next to them. But it kind of served the purpose of, you know, what they were trying to do. So yeah, so at some times you just need to keep it simple and say, when you're taking cars and you're taking guys and games and competition, and you generally will win. And so that's a smaller example of things. So this one, I actually got this 10 minutes ago from the Auto Expo. I know everyone's sitting here, so they can't see. So, and this is done by... so Roshan Abbas is also part of our company, and he runs another company called Encompass. So he kind of said, okay, fine, I want to send something so everyone can see what's happening at the expo. This is something they're doing for the Hyundai Grand. It's just a video, which is short right now, where people can actually move the car around and paint it however they want to paint it. Simple, right? It's so much fun. You have a car on a screen, you can touch and you can paint all over it, you can do what you want. Kind of gets the fun out of it. He just said that, you know, he just messaged me saying, have you done your thing? I have not done yet. So fine. So yeah, so we don't react quick enough. I think that's one thing which comes out of this, the fact that he knew I was going to do this talk. He said, maybe this is something people need to see. And so yeah, it was just short 5 minutes before I came on top here. And sometimes when you're doing stuff on ground, that's really important. You need to make sure it gets out as quickly as possible. But sometimes things can also go a little off, right? And we've all seen that. So I've had an instance of an invisible car. I will not mention either the event agency or the brand concerned. It was simple. We had to put a car in front of, we had to make it seem like a person can stand in front of the car and there was a screen behind it. And that screen would become, you know, different kinds of landscapes. Be a beach, could be a sea, and it would come out there and they'd be all excited because they're in different environments with the car itself. What happened was that what we gave them as to what should happen and what actually ended up getting set up there, let's say a couple of days before, let me just say that if you say I want a green screen behind and you end up getting a green car, kind of makes the car invisible, doesn't it, when you have to key out the backdrop. And that's a clear example of how things can really go wrong if the guys who are working on the digital part of the thing and the guys who are doing the activation don't really work together henceforth. Our mistake, we should have been there through the entire flow of things saying, and this is how each part needs to be. Their mistake, they should have actually maybe pushed us more to be part of the whole thing there. We also had made it for one guy to stand next to the car. When 20 guys stand next to the car, the background goes a little loopy and suddenly you see one headless guy, one guy without a leg, and suddenly a guy has a hole between his chest. So yes, at some point, I think that's something we really forget. We forget that someone told me a couple of days ago that digital is the unholy marriage of advertising and technology. I think it tried to make it a little more holy than it might be a little better for all of us, because we tend to work as two separate units, and if we work together, things will be a lot better. I've also been through something I call the RFID from hell. RFIDs are great technologies. You can do so many fun things with it. I go to a gym where my membership card is RFID band, where I just need to swipe onto it. I can swipe myself in and open my cabinet and all that stuff. And it's in Bombay, which is great. But I went for an event once, which was a workshop similar to this, seminar, whatever you want to call it. And so I had to first stand in a queue to register to get an idea. A piece of paper, which I had to go to counter number two to give to that guy so he give me RFID band, who would then take me, send me to an iPad on a counter a little away from there, where I had to, enter my details in, come back to him, get the code which I've gotten on my phone because I've entered my mobile phone number on the iPad, so my RFID can be connected to my Facebook account. That's a lot of work for me to sit and listen to people talk. And I kind of said, why couldn't we just be simpler? I mean, I saw a video a couple of days ago. It has nothing to do with activation, has nothing to do with digital, but it was a simple idea. It's international. I think we'll take time to get there. A general manager in a hotel realized most of the people who stay there keep throwing their swipe cards away because, a lot of times you leave your phone and the key card together, it doesn't work, you don't open the thing, you have to go back down five floors to get another card from the reception. And that happens to a lot of us. So he said, what do we do? And he and his team they said, should we use RFID? Should we use, should we use biometrics? Just the simplest way to do it, nobody's gonna lose their finger. Someone came out with the simplest of answers. They said, what if all it was your phone that we would email you a link to an app which you have to download. If you put that in front of your key, it just opens. Simple answer, right? Just use technology. What if our phones were our ways to get inside and what if it gave us the itinerary of what was going to happen? What if it gave us additional things which people have said if I've come in late? I think most people in India use their phone for everything rather than a laptop. I think the number of larger touch screens I'm seeing in the most bizarre of places, the guy who came to take kachra from the house in the morning had a nice touch screen, big phone, carbon is going on like that, and he's having a lot of fun with it. So I think we need to look at it that way. And, so just to look back at everything you've kind of spoken about, we also need to realize everything is not for everyone. Some brands should use some kinds of activations. Some brands shouldn't. I think we need to look at that. Instead of saying, what is the technology, should I do something with it? Maybe all brands shouldn't be on Facebook. I'm a digital agency, social media is bread and butter. I'm still saying, maybe all brands shouldn't be. Some brands should maybe be on Twitter, some should maybe just have a microsite. Some should, you know, some brands maybe shouldn't do, they shouldn't do activations at all. But it's important to realize what is really right for you. And this comes in there, because when you start considering an experience more than ROI, ROI kind of takes care of itself, and that's something which we've always seen. Think convenience, and just remember, it just needs to be fun. I mean, if you're excited by it, everybody will. And yeah, campaign video, please don't do that. It's, yeah, that's me. Any questions, anything? No? No one?
Oh. Oh. Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, thanks so much for letting us look at problems as opportunities via your presentation. Well, my question is more Facebook related, since it's the hype thing as of now in the digital platform. I wanted to understand from you, how important do you think is a sense of gratification to your fans to keep them engaged and loyal to your brand page? Or is there any other method that you can actually keep them engaged, except for the fact that, of course, you need to have interactive posts and a once in a while sense of gratification, freebies or gifts or something of that sort? What do you think would be the next best milestone in achieving organic likes and keeping them engaged to your brand page?
How to put it? So, this question kind of changes each time Facebook decides to change its algorithm, which they did a couple of weeks ago. They're doing a couple of changes more. But in the primary sense, what you need to do is a good mix of everything. You can have the best content on your page, but nobody will see it because you're not promoting it, right? Promoted posts work a lot better than, let's say, ads, because it's still content you're feeding people. It's not that one blurpy thing on the side saying, click on me, like my page. It's not that. But in an overall sense, I think we need to stop looking at pages as selling the brand. You need to associate your brand with something and make it a larger, you know, medium of sorts. And it's your platform to put things out there, but it can't be the only thing you do, especially in a country like India. You can't just say, okay, I have a Facebook page, I have engagement on it, and that kind of takes care of it. I've seen instances of a Facebook page of certain brands, when they first launch, will have millions of followers and have 10 people talking about it. Doesn't serve the purpose. Nobody's seeing it. So you need to do a good mix of Facebook, which is your primary base, because everybody has a Facebook account. I'm told the head of Facebook India actually she was counted third most innovative in the world because of the fact she sold Facebook Messenger as an alternative to SMS in rural areas. So we know everybody's on Facebook. And mix that with mobile capabilities in terms of, I think a web-based microsite or website is important. Everybody's looking at stuff online. Twitter, not necessarily unless you know if your brand commands it, but I think a mix of the web, of Facebook, and doing stuff which is face-to-face activation is important. You can't just do Facebook. It depends on the brand. I mean, your question's quite open-ended, so I can't really tell you what works for everyone. I'm just saying it's a case-to-case basis. Some things will work for someone. It's kind of saying, my biryani might not be your butter chicken, if that makes any sense whatsoever.
Yeah, I'm actually coming from the Tourism Office of Spain, which is a part of the Tourism Department of the Spain Consulate. So if, like, for example, we sponsor...
I didn't hear you.
I'm working for the Tourism Department of the Spanish Consulate. So, of course, what we are selling is basically tourism to Spain, like Indians aspiring or avid travelers to Spain. So if we are looking at something like a trip to Spain sort of thing that we are looking at as a gratification on our brand page, that wouldn't really serve the purpose, because it would be just like a one-off instance where we can, because it's involving a lot of budget. So, I mean, what I'm trying to understand from you is, of course, not just building posts or building content-related, like informative posts that will really help us engage our audience. What we are actually trying to understand is, what would be the next possible best thing instead of just a sense of gratification that we could offer our fans to keep them more engaged and, you know, try to, of course, Facebook advertising is one of the options, but not looking at the advertising bit of it and just trying to get more organic likes. What would be the second best option after providing like gratification?
So what, I mean, if you ask me what, if it's tourism for Spain, I haven't been to Spain, I've been to Italy, so I'll give an example from what I would really want as a person who's looking at, you know, as a tourist. Facebook will give you the flavor of what Spain is, that your posts are going to be great, you're going to talk a lot about the food, the culture, make people really want to go there. If you can do smaller case, I'll give an example of, so we help launch Magnum ice creams in India, and we need to really get the flavor of you know, the fact that it's ice cream, but it's still, you know, it's got luxury in there. We did something called a masterclass. We activated on Facebook and Twitter. We got people who were excited in that space. We got a small set of people together, did many smaller events where they actually met a chef who ran them by different kinds of desserts they could do. So, you know, if you really want to give the culture out, activating them, in the sense you activate them from Facebook, get the right bunch of people, maybe bring them together in real life, is one way of doing things. That video amplifies it in terms of saying this is what people have gone through. But I think just primarily promoted on Facebook in terms of what the content is. If it's about saying, what if you were in Spain, this is how it would be. If you have a video, for instance, which says that, you know, you just need to connect it to your Facebook and suddenly you see your face splashed all over an entire video of a person enjoying himself in Spain, like, okay, fine, the video looks nice, maybe I should really go there. And, you know, you need to make it interactive. You can't just stick to the Facebook part. So you need to either an interactive video campaign, taking people from the page and onto, you know, an actual on-ground event. I think that's the only way you're going to actually spread more, and it converts as well. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, you know, I like Spain, I'll click on it, I'll say, okay, it looks nice, and I'll feel like, okay, fine, I've never taken a holiday in 4 years, so, you know, I'm just going to look at it and feel bad about myself, and that's what will end up happening.
Thank you.
Hi, Varun. Yeah. I'm Kiran Srivastava from Molecule Communications. Amazing session, really enjoyed. My question comes is that Indian audience is usually excited by an emotional connect or something really funny and entertaining. There are various issues that happen, which is rape and dowry and this and that. And if you just kind of give a serious campaign to it, or get involved, help, blah, 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 it really doesn't, you know, make some sense. So would you suggest for a serious issue like rape or safety of women, something entertaining could be a way to engage people and make them involved into something?
A very good example. Someone already done it. There's a video that this stand-up group called All India Bakchod has done.
What
is it? So it's a group of stand-up guys. They call themselves All India Bakchod. That's their name. They have no other name for themselves, so unfortunately I have to say it that way. They've done an interesting video. I can actually, Brian, if you should check that out. It's clearly two women talking about how it's their fault that they got raped. And it's got Kalki, the actress, and Juhi Pandey, who used to be a VJ Channel V. And they're just talking about, okay, I know it's my fault that I'm wearing these clothes. I know, but it's funny. You're laughing at it, but also feeling a little like, okay, I know this is wrong. You should check it out. It went viral. I know they didn't spend on it because I know the guys. And you know, I think it's an interesting point you make. I think for serious topics, if you figure an interesting, you either shock people or you make them laugh. There are only two ways in which you're really going to spread it out there.
Yeah, because people just getting involved with an issue out of sympathy or guilt of, okay, I should also do something. More than that, if they get involved with excitement and feel that it'll be good to be part of something like that.
Totally.
So do you think there is a sync between a serious issue and an entertaining comic way to promote the issue in some way?
As long as it's done in good taste. I'll give you a clear example. Before the Super Bowl, there was this ad that came out about why kids need to stay in school. It's by far the most bizarre thing I've seen in my life. There are about two guys and two girls and who snuck out of high school and they're, you know, gone to the beach and there's la 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 music going on and they're jumping around and suddenly one girl goes onto the beach and she blows up because she's stood on her mind and then one after another they all blow up. And outside there's a board which says, you know, what bomb disposal, no, bomb testing site. be careful. So it's, and the, then you see these lines which come up saying, don't skip school, you know, how things can go wrong. But for me, that didn't hit the point at all. I'm like, that guy needs to go to school, whoever wrote that piece, because making people blow up didn't make any sense. So like, yeah, it depends on the way you put it together. I think at some point, shouldn't become only entertainment and not this. I think the balance is required. And that's really the trick. I think you should really check out this video. I mean, I'll...
Yeah, thank you. Because I was just trying to understand, because I'm not creative at all, whether it makes sense or no. Then, of course, we can explore. Thank you so much.
We're all creative. It's not...
Thanks.
Any more questions?
Yeah, done.
Yeah, I think that's it.
Cheers. Thanks.